Good afternoon, everyone. Jason here. Today is December 12th, and this is your aftermarket update. All right, we had another good day here at the Oil Trading Group. The win streak continues. We're at day 7 now on the win streak, and we are having an excellent month of December here. If you take a look up here at the price ladder, you can see that we had a net finish today of 33 ticks. We're trading one lots. Again, I can't stress that enough, that all these things that you're seeing in here are done on one lots. And so the risk is really low, and we're able to maximize these trades here on one lots. Here's your trade view statistics for today. We had a $410 one lot winning trade on the CL. I'll show you that trade here in just a few moments. We had an 8 tick losing trade. So again, if you think about what our philosophy in here, our mantra is cutting the losing trades short, letting the winning trades run. You can see that that is a 5-to-1 win, average winning trade greater than your average losing trade. Those were the only two trades that we took in here today. And I had an interesting conversation offline today. And one of the conversations was, well, why did you quit? Why did you stop trading? You were ahead. You had a good trade. Why did you stop trading? And one of the things that we talked about is we were in crude oil inventory report day. The markets weren't moving as actively as we would like to have seen them in the past. And once you get up a good chunk of ticks like we did here today, 33 ticks, I really was just kind of cherry picking and waiting for that right opportunity that for me never really presented itself. And then I had another interesting conversation where the person that I was talking to mentioned that it's hard for them and to, well, it was a new person, and they didn't understand, like yesterday, why it is that I continued to press into this area where I was looking to get short, right? And the market ultimately takes off to the downside at the end of the day. And if you watched yesterday's video, I showed you where I was down ticks and then ended up being up a bunch of ticks by the time the day was over because I took two single trades that made all the difference in the world. And this person was like, well, I just don't know if I can handle a high losing percentage. And that really got me thinking that I'm sure there's a lot of traders out there that have that same type of mentality. So what I thought I would do really quickly is just talk to you about the psychology of getting out. For me personally, I have gotten to a point in my trading where win percentage doesn't mean anything to me. Your win percentage is not where you are getting paid. Where you get paid as a trader is in your reward to risk ratios. And there are going to be some of you out there that go, well, aren't those the same thing? And the answer is actually no, right? And one of the examples we use is I can have a 90, if I told you had a 90% win rate on one system and a 10% win rate on the other system, which one is better? And the answer is incomplete, because if on the 90% winning trades, if you take one tick wins, and on the 10th trade you take in a 10 or 11 tick stop, then your 10% loser wipes out your entire win percentage at 90%. And conversely, if you have 9 one-tick losing trades and 1 11-tick winning trade, then that 10% win rate is the better system. And so it's all about, for me, what is my reward to risk ratio? What am I getting? I am looking for a minimum of 2.5-to-1 reward to risk on my trades. I don't always get there. Sometimes I get a little higher like we did today. And sometimes we get a little bit lower than that, but averaging it all in, that is where we strive to be. So if you look at us during this win percent or during this winning streak, and again, we didn't trade last Wednesday. That was the memorial for President Bush. So if you come back here to Monday the 3rd, and just so you can see this again, the holiday, the Saturday was the 1st, Sunday was the 2nd. We began our trading week here, and we have won every day this week and into last week. And if you click filter, you'll see here that we're up on one lots, nearly $5,000 on one lots, right? And look at the win rate. The win rate here is 40%. So that's not a huge win rate, right? But if you look at the average winning trade at 371, and you look at the average losing trade of 123, that is a 3-to-1 reward to risk ratio. And so too many times I'll talk to traders who will say, yeah, I have a whole bunch of small winning trades, and then I have that one bad trade that wipes out all of my wins, and then I'm stuck with a losing week. So I would rather go with the idea of small loser, small loser, small loser, big winner, wipe out all the smaller winning trades and days, right? Or losing, sorry, the one big winning trade to wipe out all of the small losing trades. Then what happens when you take trades off at 5 and 6 ticks and you have 10 tick stops? You have a couple of those in a row, and there's going to be a few of you out there that are going to understand what I'm saying. When I talk to a lot of traders and they tell me they have a great Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and then Friday they give it all back, or in some combination of that. Whereas if you are at a 3-to-1, 2.5-to-1, like we're averaging here, 3-to-1 reward to risk on one lots, then you can have a low win percentage, because who cares what the win percentage is. You can then, if you have the right reward to risk ratio, then your trading is going to be much more consistent. You're going to be much more consistent at the end of the day, right? And that's where we are at this 7-day win streak. So hopefully that makes sense, and hopefully that clears up confusion. I got asked a lot yesterday. You kept trying to get short up here, Jason. Why did you keep, and let me see if we can find it here really quickly. It was back in this area here, right? You kept trying to get short. You kept trying to get short. You were looking for this target down here, and you kept getting stopped out with small stops, and I did. But eventually, we caught a 50-tick winner that all but erased my losing trades, and then I had a couple of really nice ES trades that put me way over the top yesterday. And so as long as I am within my parameters of my reward to risk, and I can be there with one lot, right, then at the end of the day, you can have a bunch of small losing trades and a low win percentage and still be able to be on a 7-day win streak with a $5,000 profit on one lots, right? So again, hopefully that makes sense to you. And let's talk about today's CL trade. We were, as we got into this morning together, one of the things that we talked about was that we were at Crude Oil Inventory Report Wednesday. We were looking for a pattern here to get short off of this structure mid. Market opens up here, rallies into this 89 high. We talked about the fact that you just barely cleared out the highs here. We got back below our structure signal. And one of the things that we talk about in the way that we look at our levels is we talk about kick the signal and pay the target. Well, you have two targets on this chart. You have one above you, which it did not reach out to, which is our indication that we're looking for the market to come down to this structure target down below. And so as the market began this process of going through and kind of rotating around, this shaded area, by the way, represents the zone of influence around this support and resistance area. And so what we were talking about is getting in short up here. And what we ultimately did is get in short the first time at 38. It took me out at 8 ticks, and then we got in short again. And we were looking to target this structure signal. And we talked about in the trade room that if we talked about getting into the 70s, in fact, 73 was your structure signal underneath. And what we had talked about is that if it broke down through that, then you were going to be looking to carry it down to this structure target into the 20s. And one of the things that we commiserated about is that if it was not Crude Oil Inventory Report Wednesday, then there was going to be a pretty good likelihood that we could make it down to that step below. Well, the market comes in. We ultimately come all the way down here into 86. I get trail stopped on my 38 short up here at 97. And then the market just kind of rotates around, moves down through it, back and forth, really. We had this big rally. We had our sweet spot retracement, which we talked about in the room up here today. And then, of course, the market kind of rotates around for the balance of the afternoon. And then right at the close today, we talk about kick the signal and pay the target. And that's how these levels work, right? We look for this thing to come on down here. We didn't trade any of that. We had the one trade here where we got in short just ahead of the announcement at 38, and we got trail stopped out at 97 for, or 87, 97? Yeah, we 97, right, sorry, for a 41-tick trade, and that ends up being our trade of the day. And so, again, we did extend our winning streak out to a 7th consecutive day. And so we're going to invite you here tomorrow to come in and take a look and see if we can extend it to an 8th day. Right now, what I'm going to do here is show you that trade of the day, and I'll do it as we always do it. I'll put a little music behind it. You'll hear where I get in. You'll see where the entries are. You'll see that I'm down 8 ticks. When you look at the first part of the video, you'll see I'm down 8 ticks. And then we'll transition into the trade itself. I'll cut it into pieces, speed it up, put some music behind it so you kind of get a feel for what the trade looked like. And then, of course, you'll get to see where we get taken out. And then you can match that price ladder at the end of the day with this price ladder here. And you'll see that that is exactly as it happened in the trade room. So without further ado, here is that OTG trade of the day. I'm in at 38 short. Stop here is 53. Target is 70s down below you. I'm in 38 short here.